saw you from afar, but we locked eyes quick. He liked the way you like to mesmerize. And not every time I see you every night, you look like every light in my eyes.
First of all, I'm very sorry that my background isn't aesthetically pleasing as I am. This video is poor quality, I'm sorry. It's what you want. So first we're gonna start out with rose water. So I have this rose water that I made. And if you wanna learn how to make it, I'll link something down below where I learned it, or you can just buy some like a bougie person. Skin has not been good the past couple of days. So we'll get rid of that soon. I'm using this. I have two of these. I have this Coco Shea cucumber really refreshing aloe gel lotion with cocoa extract, shea butter extract, and cucumber water. It's very lightweight and conditioning, and it's not wrong. I got this from Bath & Body Works. It's like a gel. There was a honey one and a coconut one, but I prefer this one because I just like the feel of it. It smells good. It smells like cucumber. I'm just going to use a little. A little goes a long way. I'm going to use this Maybelline Master Prime Blur and Smooth Primer. My spoolie. It looks ghetto, but that's okay. And I'm just gonna be combing up my brows. Here's my little brush. It's actually an eyeliner brush, but I use it for my eyebrows because I want to be precise. It's actually a jumbo eye pencil, and it's black. It's really, really black. But I do a little trick where it makes it look more natural and doesn't look where it's like, you know? And I saw this trick from a girl here on YouTube. It's not even a trick. I'm pretty sure so many people have been doing this, but I like saw it from her first. Kelsey Simone. She's so cool. And I love her aesthetic. And I want to be her. So I'm just putting this line under my eyebrow. And I know that looks like a cartoon. And this is the look. See you guys later. Subscribe. And so I'm going to take my spoolie. I know what I look like. And I'm just gonna comb it upwards and just blend it into my eyebrows. This saves a lot of time, a lot of product, and also makes your eyebrows look natural. So. Alright, so those are our eyebrows. And yeah. I'm gonna carve out the brow. And I'm taking this concealer brush from God knows where. And I'm going to be taking, I've already used this a lot as you can tell, but I'm going to be taking this color right here. And I would get a concealer that matches your skin tone, and it's not lighter than your skin tone. So I'm going to carve out my brow. Alright, so that's one eyebrow compared to the other eyebrow. Hopefully that looks good enough for YouTube. Okay, and we're back with both eyebrows done. Okay, so what I'm going to do next is foundation and concealer. And I'm going to be using this Maybelline Matte Poreless Foundation. Obviously, in 112 Natural Ivory. And then I'm going to be using the one that's just like this, except it's 114. I think it's called Ivory. I don't want to show it on camera because it's like kind of broken because somebody knocked it over. I'm not gonna say names. Nigel. But I usually put it the lighter shade in the middle of my face and the darker shade on the outer parts of my face, not to like contour or anything, but just to give dimension. Also, I do have freckles. They're real. Eat your heart out. And I'm not using the sponge, probably one of the best foundation brushes, even though it's a powder brush, that you can use ever, is the e.l.f. Flat Top Kabuki Brush, even though it says a power brush. I don't care if you are bougie, I don't care if you are broke, this is probably one of the best foundation brushes you will ever blend with in your life. And this, obviously, it's much more bouncy, and we're just blending. And When you blend, you gotta blend until it's blended, okay? I've seen, ugh, too many cake faces I've seen. If you think it's blended, blend more. Next thing I'm going to do is a little bit of concealer. And I think I'm going to try to trust it this time, because now that I'm more tan, I can use it. Radiant Creamy Concealer. Oh god, and it's in the color Light 3 in Honey. I usually couldn't use it before because it was too dark. But now that I'm a little bit more tan, I can try to use it, I guess. And if you don't want to use the NARS Creamy Radiant Concealer, whatever the heck, I would suggest using the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer because it's just as good. This is a little bit more thick. I kind of have a love-hate relationship with it. Airspun Loose Powder. And I have my CoverGirl Loose Powder. Both of them are amazing. I think I'm gonna use this one. I'm taking this It Cosmetics fluffy brush and I just dip that in there. And I don't like powdering my whole face because it makes my face look cakey. It makes a lot of people's faces look cakey. And it just, I don't know, it just doesn't give me a look that I like. So I'm just gonna. To take this powder brush from e.l.f. It's a complexion brush. I'm not gonna do too much with my eyes because I'm not in the summer now. I'm taking this palette that I got for my birthday. It's the Urban Decay Alice Through the Looking Glass palette. It's really dope. Can you open it up? And I'm going to start out with a light shadow. I'm going to use the color Looking Glass, which is a pale pink. And I'm going to mix that with Royal Flush, which is a more shimmery pink. And I'm going to mix that with Lily, which is a like champagne color. Because I just like them all together. Take a little bit of Duchess, just like this peachy color, and I'm gonna mix that a little bit with Dormouse. A little bit of Paradox, which is this orange color, which may look scary, but I want to mix that with Duchess again to make a nice pretty champagne apricot color. I want to go with something kind of peachy today, kind of neutral. Now I'm going to do that. This is probably my favorite color in the whole entire palette. It's called Chessboard, and it's this beautiful matte neutral brown. And I really, really like it. And so I'm taking a little bit of that, and I use this all the time. I wish they had like a single shadow of it, because I love it. And I'm just going to put that on the outer corner crease, right there, of the eye. What a coincidence. You know, now I'm just waiting for anything to happen. You know, there could be like a bomb that would fall off. Like, there could be like a circus coming outside my door. Or, you know, like a party. Who knows? Okay, so that's our eyeshadow. I'm taking this brush. I'm using this little baby part. And I'm going to take a dark shadow, such as this one from the same palette, called Chronosphere, and it's a little bit shimmery, which I don't like because I wanted it to be natural and matte, but who cares? I don't think anyone's really gonna see it. I'm gonna take this dark shadow. I'm gonna go along my lash line because since we want to keep it kind of low key and natural, I just want to create eyeliner without it being eyeliner. I'm not doing a wing or anything. I'm just gonna do just subtle, making my lash line look darker. Deciding on whether I should do lashes or not, because I want this to be kind of universal to everyone. No lashes, we're not doing lashes today. Is that I know y'all are gonna hate the fact that I'm using this, but I don't have curly lashes. And if you do, lucky you. I'm using an eyelash curler, and I know these are scary and everyone else hates them, but you gotta have patience, and you just can't move. That's all. I'm looking around the room. Because I've been doing my makeup since I was like in fifth grade. Maybe even more than that, who knows. And now we're gonna take one of my favorite mascaras, which is from the drugstore. And it's the Maybelline Mega Plush Volume Express Hydro Fuge, which has like mousse in it. Not like mousse, but mousse. And yeah, it's waterproof and it's really nice. I think I like Maybelline a lot. Maybelline's a really good makeup brand. And yeah, we're just gonna do our eyelashes. Now we're gonna go with like, the rest of the face. I'm gonna be taking this really old CoverGirl. I'm gonna be taking this really empty that I accidentally took from my friend like 2 years ago. Bronzer in 305 Fantastic Bronze from CoverGirl. Sorry, Emily. I told you I would give it back and then I realized that I broke it and I just knew that there was no coming back after that, but I will buy you a new one, I swear. That Tarte blush and just smiling, and I don't put it on the apples of my cheeks. I put it right there because that makes my face look like a clown. And yeah, it's very subtle, very natural looking. You can still kind of see it, right? And now we're moving on to the glow. Whee! My favorite part. I really regret not putting this under my foundation because now it's gonna look kind of weird, I guess. Yeah, where's the product? There's the product. So it looks like that. And I'm taking this fluffy brush, and sometimes I'll do it with the brush, sometimes I won't. But today, we'll just do it with the brush, because why not? And I start with liquid, and then I go to powder, because I still love glowing, no matter what kind of consistency it is. King Tut highlighter from Jeffree Star, and the reason why I'm holding it like this is because a travesty happened. Yeah, try not to cry. I know. I did. I definitely did. This is $24. $24, and somebody broke it, and it wasn't me because I wasn't home when this happened. It could have been my sister falling because we could have glowed. It's holding my hands, but you know, I'm still gonna put it on the collarbone. Put that. I used to not be able to use this highlighter because it was too dark for my skin tone. Now that I'm a bit tanner for the summer, I can use it. I'm not really gonna go crazy blinding, even though it might look like that, but oh god. That was a bit much, don't you think, Allie? Now you look like Nikki Tutorials. Not like that's a bad thing, of course, but you know. She does love her glow and maybe a little bit more. Easy looking. There we go. We're getting there. It's looking a little bit more makeup-y and not like I'm a satellite-ish. Okay, now that we're done with the glow, I'm gonna go with lips. And I'm deciding whether I like this pink gloss or this clear gloss that I have. But I think I want to do the clear gloss because we all kind of, we just want to make it dewy and glowy and pretty. So I'm taking this clear gloss from MAC Studio and I'm just... Those are our lips. So yeah, this is the finished look. I'm gonna do some really awkward hot poses and then yeah, that's it. Yeah, I'll be back with some really awkward sexy posing. I'm not sexy, so yeah.
You said you've never been melted before. Your heart's never really dripped on the floor. You don't.
Hi. Guys, I'm so not bougie. I guess we're gonna have to talk over the lawnmower. But anything to mess up Allie's audio, you know? And there's that. Yes, come on, Glow. Oh my gosh, shut up! It is. I just hit my ankle. That lawnmower is gonna have to chill because I'm going to punch it in the face. I kind of look like a drag queen, and I just hit my ankle again. And then my dog start barking. Of course. Oh. Yeah. So now that we're done, that... Also, I'm sick. Nigel! He's stupid. He didn't know where he's looking. It's gonna look a little extreme. I know. Okay. Really, really hate that car that just went by. I'm using NARS Rainy Creamient, really?
And I usually couldn't use it before, but my Lamborghini Gelato.
Is he dead? Nigel. Want some chicken?
Is he dead?
Want some chicken?
Oh, okay. He's dead. Anytime I say the word, and no, it's a weird word. Anytime I say the word Mogwai in a really high-pitched, like, throaty voice, he always does something.
Mogwai!
Every time.
Did you neutral? My favorite color?
So,
take it. Stop licking, please. heaven for that. I don't look like a drag queen, even though I want to sometimes. And now the last one. Ooh, girl, that is a look! It's
not. Okay.